Newly appointed pool body chairman George Garcia vows to lead with impartiality and independence and to introduce much-needed reforms to the Commission on Elections. Willard Chang reports.
Commission on Elections Chairperson George Erwin Garcia presided over his first virtual unbanked meeting a day after taking his oath of office. In his first press conference, Garcia vowed to institute structural reforms to strengthen good governance, accountability, transparency, and integrity, and elevate standards of competence in the poll body. His marching orders to COMELEC personnel:
the right thing. We are here to protect democracy and affirm the mandate of the people. Do the right thing. What is the right thing? Avoid anything that is not right.
Garcia says he will remain impartial and independent, vowing to protect the institution and inhibit from cases involving former clients, including President Marcos, as he did when he first served as commissioner of the poll body.
Isang term lang ang Pangulong Bongbong Marcos hanggang 2028, so hindi naman po siya tatakbo na. Kung ano man po yung kaso na may darating sa amin na mag-i-involve siya, o kahit na sinong kliyente ko before na nahawakan ko, whether in the past, definitely, mark my word, I will inhibit. Wala po ako mapapala kung magpa-participate ako. Natutulik sa inpa ko ng sambayan ng Pilipino, magkakaroon ng duda, hindi lang sa akin, kung hindi sa institution. I always protect the institution. Hindi na baling nawala ako, hindi ako na-confirm, natandaan nyo naman yun, it's okay. But the institution's integrity is intact.
Among Garcia's plans is to open all procurement to the public and media, create a COMELEC Academy to train all COMELEC personnel on the commission's work, create COMELEC marshals to enforce COMELEC orders, and create the Office of COMELEC Spokesperson as a permanent entity. He also plans to lead the poll body's first flag raising during the pandemic on Monday. Garcia also hopes to include in the poll body's budget proposal next year the construction of a building in its property in Pasay to house the COMELEC offices and warehouse to do away with leasing offices that cost the poll body several millions. The COMELEC reiterated that all of its servers and secure vaults are safe, intact, undamaged, and unaffected. A fire that hit the reception area of the Information Technology Department at the 7th floor of Palacio del Gobernador. COMELEC led reporters to a tour of the area to show that no data were compromised, pointing out that the electronic election results and data remain to be posted on its website. The Bureau of Fire Protection is looking at the possibility that a damaged uninterruptible power supply or UPS unit caused the fire.
Yung initial investigation natin ay nagmula po sa ilalim ng computer table. So doon sa initial results, napansin ng ating mga investigator na sunog na sunog po yung UPS. So ito po yung dahilan bakit natin dinala sa arson laboratory namin, sa national headquarters, para malaman po kung may defective na po yung UPS natin.
Hinihintay po namin yung kanilang final report, but it appears and it is apparent already na wala po talagang foul play, wala pong design, walang arson, kundi talaga pong meron po silang tinitignan na faulty equipment or electrical wirings po.
The COMELEC suspended its frontline services, including the issuance of voter certification, advising the public to process requests with their local election office in the meantime. Physical reporting to majority of the offices in the main office will resume Thursday, except for seniors, pregnant, and people with disabilities, and those with comorbidities who may continue to work from home. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
COMELEC Chairman Garcia says he respects President Marcos's decision to veto a measure giving tax breaks to poll workers. He defends the president, saying the move is not meant to discredit the efforts of election personnel. Garcia adds other forms of assistance could be offered to them.
Narinig ko po ang ating Pangulo ng ipaliwanag po niya yung pong kadahilanan at ang kanyang proposal din. Magkataon po natutuwa po ako na halos parehas po kami ng idea dahil sa yung pong tax exemption na ating pong sanang igagawad o ibibigay sa ating mga poll watchers ay pwede naman pong bakunan talaga doon sa bakit hindi na lang po natin i-increase halimbawa yung allowance honoraria na pwede namin maibigay sa kanila. Lalo't lalo na may budget naman po kami kesa halimbawa halimbawa po yung budget na yan, halimbawa po excess o yung matitira ay kung saan mapunta, kaibigay na lang po namin sa mga guro o sa iba pang mga poll workers na magtilingkod po sa araw na election. O kaya naman po, pag sila yung nagte-training, pwede po namin taasan yung mga training honoraria na binibigay po namin.
Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel stresses the importance of better coordination between the legislative and executive branches of government. That's after President Marcos vetoed five measures that were already passed by the 18th Congress. Pimentel suggests immediately activating the Presidential Legislative Liaison Office so lawmakers can start working on the administration's priority bills and prevent a repeat of successive vetoes.
Yun na, mas madaling i-activate kasi ang litak. Very formal pa, tatawagin mo ilang tao yan. Pwede naman siyang bumisita na sa Senado, mag-request siya ng meeting with the senators o kung sino man na mag-attend. I-brief na niya, oh, ito yung 19 na priority legislation, ano yung mga laman nito. So para klaro na, like yung right sizing na yan. Ano lang yan eh, term lang yan eh. Priority legislation daw ang right sizing. Term lang po yan, konsepto lang yan. Ang importante malaman yung detalye eh.
The lower chamber has elected its delegates to two powerful bodies, the Commission on Appointments and the House of Representatives Electoral Tribunal. For the CA, the House elected Pangasinan Representative Ramon Guico Jr., Cavite Congresswoman Lani Mercado, Camarines Sur Representative El Rey Villafuerte, and Sagip Party List Representative Rodante Marcoleta, among others. They will have a say on who sits in the Marcos administration as they can confirm or reject presidential appointees. Meanwhile, Davao's Vincent Garcia and Cebu Representative Pablo John Garcia were among those elected to the House of Representatives Electoral Tribunal. They are tasked to resolve electoral protests and cases pertaining to House lawmakers. A bill penalizing political turncoatism filed at the lower house, the author, former president, and now senior deputy speaker Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. Under the proposed measure, party members are not allowed to switch affiliation 1 year before or after any national elections. Violations will have a penalty of forfeiting their elective office or disqualification from the next election. The Political Party Development Act of 2022 also seeks to institutionalize political parties and prescribes procedures for its registration before the Philippine poll body. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel says this bill is more likely to pass in Congress than anti-political dynasty measures.
Ang pagreforma sa lipunan, lalo na sa sistema ng politika natin, gawin na lang natin itong evolution, hindi revolution. Evolution, ibig sabihin nun, dahan-dahan, kung ano yung kaya natin gawin, kunin na natin. So, imbis na, let us say, anti-political dynasty law na alam na natin na i-oppose ng lahat ng members ng dynasty dyan sa lawmaking body, mas may pag-asa pa itong anti-political turncoatism.
A political analyst, meanwhile, wants some changes to the bill.
Bagamat natutuwa ako at nabuhay na naman yung usapin tungkol dito, binabasa ko nga, meron din akong mga hindi sang-ayon. Like halimbawa, bakit 1 year lang? Dapat 3 years. Dapat 3 years, kasing electoral cycle, 3 years eh. Paano mo naman maaano yung loyalty mo kung hindi naman uminit yung upuan mo dun sa partido na yon? Dapat at least 3 years ka na member ng party bago ka tumakbo under that party. Itong current version ni Congresswoman Arroyo, walang mention ng barangay. Parang hindi ba dapat mas maganda kung magsisimula sa grassroots?
Justice Secretary Boyeng Remulla vows to provide the International Criminal Court with details on the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs. That's ahead of a September 8th deadline set by the ICC for the Philippines to comment on whether its prosecutor should be allowed to resume its probe into the anti-narcotics campaign. Remulla says among the information they will provide are supposed proof that the justice system in the country is working and why there's no need for the ICC to step in.
I think it is indisputable that our courts are functioning. The prosecution is functioning. This means that we have a functioning judicial system. So I don't think that there's any deprivation involved here, since what is involved is domestic law and the way that we run our country. And it is a democratic country.
There are no more unabated killings as of today. In fact, record shows that there are no unenforced disappearances or torture in the last 3 years. And that means the government is in place and in control. So that is what we believe in, and that is what excludes the ICC from exercising its powers over us. Our institutions are intact and working.
Remulla also claims his agency will spare no one in its review of drug war killings. That's amid criticism top government officials are not part of ongoing investigations.
Kahit sino pa, wala naman tayo sinasanto eh. Kahit sino pa yan, di ba? Bakit nyo ba sasabihin na hindi namin kayang gawin itong bagay na ito? Eh, nasubukan nyo ba yung aming will para maayos lahat yan, di ba? Para naman sobrang loaded yan na you're already presuming something that is not there as a fact. Hindi naman fact yun eh. Diba? I think that's too biased for us to even consider a statement like that.